Okay, so let us recall quickly what we have done in previous class. So in previous class we have differentiated between kinetics and kinematics. So kinetics is the branch of dynamics that deals with the causes of motion, that is force and masses, whereas kinematics is the branch of dynamics which deals with the motion parameters or geometry of the motion without considering or without looking into the causes and interrelationship between the mass and acceleration of the body. I hope everybody is on same page with me as far as this is concerned. Then we also discussed three fundamental geometrical quantities of the motion, and those are position, velocity and acceleration. So we have discussed all these quantities are vector quantities, they are not scalar quantities. Similarly, we differentiated between the distance traveled and change in position during a given interval of time. I hope all these differences have sunken in your mind. We also discussed when do we call the velocity as average velocity and when what is instantaneous velocity. These two things we have discussed in the previous class. Similarly, we talked about instantaneous acceleration and average acceleration. We talked about when do we call average acceleration or instantaneous acceleration as positive and negative. Similarly, average velocity and instantaneous velocity as positive and negative. This has been done in previous class. To summarize, if the velocity is in positive direction of the motion, or assume positive direction of the motion, then we call the velocity as positive, otherwise negative. Mind you, all this talk was going on in context with rectilinear motion. So we were studying the motion along a straight line of an object treated as a particle. Now, in rectilinear motion, though the quantities like position, velocity and acceleration are vector quantities, we can deal with them as scalars by assigning the sign positive and negative. So the sense of direction in case of rectilinear motion is through the positive or negative sign of a particular quantity. We also discussed that we can have positive acceleration for two descriptions of motion. If the object is speeding up in positive x direction, the acceleration will be positive. If the objective is slowing down in negative x direction, still the acceleration is going to be positive. So we were till this point in the yesterday's class, and I hope I have summarized them concisely. Now, let us go ahead. So Aftab, can you unmute yourself? I have sent you the request. Please accept that and unmute yourself. Aftab.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So let us now go ahead. Now let me ask you a question. We have already defined velocity as rate of change of position. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Time rate of change of position is velocity, dx by dt. And in rectilinear motion, the velocity will be directed along a straight line in the direction of motion, either in positive or negative direction. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, instead of representing this as v bar and instead of representing this as x bar, I have simply said v is equal to dx by dt. The direction will be taken care of by positive and negative sign of velocity. Happy?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity with reference to time, dv by dt. And its sign direction will be taken care of by positive and negative sign in case of rectilinear motions. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But the positive and negative sign of acceleration has much more complex meaning than positive and negative sign of velocity. We have discussed that in yesterday's class. Now let us rearrange the terms in the first expression. So if I take this dt on left hand side, I get v dt is equal to dx. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And dt and dx are infinitesimally small quantities. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So they are, these quantities are tending to zero, but they are not zero. That's what we have to understand. What do we mean physically by infinitesimally small number? That we will discuss a little while later. Are you with me?
Okay, sir.
Okay. And now let us go to the next relationship, a dv by dt. So if v dt is equal to dx, I can rearrange it in this form and I get 1 by dt is equal to v upon dx. Do you agree with me? So substituting that in the second relationship, I will get a equal to v dv by dx. 1 by dt ko v by dx substitute kiya hai. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nehal, are you already in the meeting or not? No, he is not. So, why is he joining from two accounts? Anyway, now, so ADX, I can rearrange the terms here and I can write it as ADX is equal to VDV. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if you look at this expression, this is the first order linear differential equations. Have you studied differential equations before this?
Yes, sir.
So this is first order linear. So what do we mean by first order? First order means it includes the first derivatives. It doesn't include d square v by dx square. It doesn't include d cube v by dx cube. So it includes derivatives only up to the first level. Therefore, we call it as first order differential equation. And why do we call it as linear? So if you look at the power of dv by dx, it is 1. It is not 2, 3, 4. Do you understand? So therefore, we call it as linear first order differential equation. And for any meaningful physical conclusion for a problem, we have to solve this linear differential equation. Are you with me?
Yes.
Now, we are going to deal with three kinds of problems in rectilinear motions. So instead of theoretically describing the problems, I have stated those problems in this fashion. So let us solve these three problems and then we will understand each problem has its own class. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Sure. So can you read out the statement of first problem for me?
The acceleration of a particle is directly proportional to the time t. At t equals to 0, the velocity of the particle is v, 16 inches per second.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing that v equals to 15 inches per second and that x equals to t inches, when t equals to 1 second, determine the velocity, the position and the total distance traveled when time equals to 7 seconds.
Great. So now lot of information is given here. Let us first put down that information in notational form. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So the first statement, acceleration is directly proportional to time t. So can I write it as a is equal to k times t?
Yes, sir.
Where k is a constant. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
K is constant with reference to time. With reference to time. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let us replace this A by the definition dv by dt. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Dv by dt is equal to k times t. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Let me call this as first equation. Let me call this as second equation. Now, further, if I replace v by dv by dt, so what dx by dt, so what do I get? D of dx by dt, are you with me?
Yes,
by
sir.
Dt is equal to kt. Happy?
Yes.
This I am going to call it as third equation. Now what is d of dx by dt with reference to dt? So can I write it as d square x by dt square, second derivative of position with reference to time. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Is equal to kt. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, for any meaningful inference or any meaningful conclusion from this differential equation, we need to integrate this equation twice. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So if I integrate the equation once, what do I get? I get dx by dt, which is also equal to v. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So I am integrating both the sides with reference to t once. So I get dx by dt as the integration with reference to time of left hand side term, which also is equal to velocity. And on right hand side, what is the integration of t? Tell me.
T square.
Yes, t square by 2.
By 2.
Do you agree with me?
Yes.
But as this is indefinite integral, we have to add constant of integration as well. Do you agree with me? So c1. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, in this expression for velocity, how many constants are there? Can you tell me? One is k and another is c1. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Both these constants are unknowns.
Yes.
Agreed? So now, how do we obtain these two constants? So they go, first condition is given at t equal to 0, velocity of the particle is 16 inch per second. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So at t equal to 0, velocity is given as 16 inch per second. Happy? I am going to simply substitute this value in equation number 5. So if I substitute these values in equation number 5, what do I get? Velocity, which is 16, must be equal to t. I have to substitute as 0. Do you agree with me? So I get c1 equal to 16. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Is there any doubt? Hai?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, to get k, I am going to require one more condition. And that is also given. What is the condition? Dekho, knowing that the velocity is 15 inch per second when time is equal to 1 second. Yeah.
Yes.
So the second condition, when time is equal to 1 second, velocity is equal to how much? 16 inch per second. 15 inch per second. I'm sorry. Are you with me?
Yes.
Per second. So if I substitute this back in this equation, what do I get? Tell me. So I get velocity, which is 15 inch per second for time t equal to 1 second. So I will have to substitute here 1. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Upon 2 plus c1. But c1 value is already known. C1 value is 16. Happy?
Yes.
Now, so what is the value of k?
Minus 2.
So k value turns out to be, this 16 goes on other side, it becomes minus 1. Minus 1 into 2, that is minus 2. So k becomes minus 2. Happy?
Yes.
So we have obtained in the process c1 as well as k. Chalo. Now, let us integrate this equation once more. Let us integrate. So this equation number 5 is going to take the shape of dx by dt. Dx by dt is equal to minus 2 by 2 into t square. So it is minus t square. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Plus c1. But c1 is how much? C1 is 16. So I will place that as 16. So this is the new form of equation number 5 after evaluating the values of k and c1. Happy?
Yes.
So this is the equation dx by dt. Whenever you see different differential quantities or incremental quantities like dx and dt, unless we integrate, we are not going to make any physical interpretations. Are you with me? So integration is pending. Yes, samajh lena. Now let me integrate both the sides with reference to t once. Are you with me? So if I perform that integration, what do I get? X is equal to, what is the integration of t square? Tell me.
T cube by 3.
So it is going to be minus sine as it is, t cube by 3. What is the integration of 16?
16t.
So it is 16 times t. And plus, you are going to introduce a new constant of
Constant.
integration because it is indefinite integration. Are you with me? That
Yes.
constant, I am going to call it as C2. Happy?
Yes.
I need to evaluate this constant as well. So I need one more condition, and that is given. What is the condition? X is equal to 20 inches when t equal to 1 second.
Yes.
Are you with me? So I am going to now use that condition. What is the condition? X is equal to 20 inches when t equal to 1 second. Are you with me?
Yes.
So substitute this t equal to 1 second here. So what do I get? Let me call this equation as equation number 7. So if I substitute this in equation number 7, what do I get? 20 is equal to, do you agree with me? Minus 1 cube, sorry, minus 1 cube divided by 3 plus 16 into 1 plus C2. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So it is minus 1 third plus 16 plus C2. Is equal to 20. So tell me what is the value of C? Calculate.
11 by 3.
It is 11 by
3.
Very good. So C2 is 11 by 3. So what is the value of X? Tell me. Minus T cube by 3. Minus T cube by 3 plus 16T. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Plus C2, but C2 is 11 by 3. Happy?
Yes, sir.
I hope you have not made any mistake here.
No, sir.
Okay. So, plus 11 by 3. This is the expression for position. Mind you, X is the expression for position. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Do we have the expression for velocity now? Yes. What is the expression for velocity? Where is the expression? Chalo batao.
Sir, equation number 5.
Equation number 6. This is velocity. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So this is the expression for velocity. And do we have velocity expression for acceleration? Yes. K is already known. How much is K? Tell me, minus 2.
Minus 2.
Minus 2 humne kar diya na. So therefore, we have expression for acceleration as well. So I will write down those equations. Velocity is equal to, tell me, what is velocity? Minus t square plus 16. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
And what is the expression for acceleration? Minus 2t. Happy?
Yes.
Velocity. Yes. Excellent. Now what is asked? Now let us look at what is asked. Determine the velocity, position and total distance traveled. Dekho, wording kya hai? You have not been asked what is the change in position. You have been asked what is the total distance traveled. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So first of all, let us calculate velocity and position. That is easy. For that, we have direct equations. So, chalo, how do I find out velocity? Determine the velocity. T is equal to 7 seconds. Are you with me? So, how do I find out velocity?
Yes, the sixth equation mein values dalni padi.
So, in this equation, I will write T is equal to 7 seconds. So, 7 square plus 16. Do you agree with me? And I will denote this as V7. What is V7? It is velocity at t equal to 7 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes.
And how much is that? Tell me.
So 33 minus 33.
So minus 33. And what will be the unit? Inch. Per second.
Per second.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the position at time t equal to 7 seconds? So I need to find out position. Mind you, change in position is not asked. You have been asked to find out the position at t equal to 7 seconds. So it is nothing but x7. You have to understand this notation. V7 means velocity at time t equal to 7 seconds. And x7 means it is the position at time t equal to 7 seconds. Mind you, it is not change in position from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 7. It is the position at time t equal to 7 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what do we need to do? We need to substitute 7 here. So it is minus 7 cube upon 3. We agree? Plus
yes.
16 into 7 plus 11 by 3. Tell me how much is that?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, it is not 11 by 3, it is 13 by 3.
C2. 13 by 3. So that means I have to calculate now. So give me a minute. So 16 threes are 48. 48 by 3. 48 minus, so it is 47 by 3. 47 by 3 goes on that side. So it is, yes, it should be 13 by 3. You are right.
Yes.
Correct. It is 13 by 3. So we have to substitute here 13 by 3. And so here also you will have to substitute 13 by 3. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Chalo, so tell me what is the value. Minus 7 cube upon 3 plus 16 into 7 plus 13 by 3. How much?
Sir, triple 2.
Pardon?
Sir, triple 2.
Pardon?
Sir, 2, 2, 2.
Minus ya plus? Wo bolo pehle.
Sir, plus. Na sir.
नहीं कुछ तो गड़बड़ की प्लस है क्या मतलब पक्का है प्लस माइनस सेवन
प्लस टू
हाँ प्लस
प्लस टू टू
प्लस
टू
ओनली टू
यस सर
प्लस टू इंचेस इज इट करेक्ट समबडी इंडिपेंडेंटली कंफर्म Somebody confirm in chat box, so it's correct, then I will go ahead. Yes, it is correct. So it is plus 2 inches, right? And now this question is most critical question. What is the total distance traveled when time is equal to 7 seconds? For this, we are going to have a digress first. Digress का मतलब होता है changing the topic, विषय अंतर. Let us have that first. So imagine the motion of a particle that at t equal to 0 second, the particle was here at origin. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Ashur. Let us say it travels a distance of, this is t equal to 10 seconds, it travels a distance of 300 feet in 10 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then it comes back. Its velocity is changed and it comes back and occupies this position at t equal to 15 seconds. Are you able to imagine the motion?
Yes, sir.
And this distance is 200 feet. 200 feet. And let us say I gave you the equation of this motion and I ask you to find out the position at t equal to 15 seconds. So what will be the answer? Tell me. With reference to this as the origin. At t equal to 15 seconds, what will be the position?
Tell me. 100 feet.
Pardon? Yes, it will be plus 100 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But what will be the total distance traveled? Total distance traveled will be 300 plus 200. Do you agree with me? So total distance traveled, distance D will be equal to 300 plus 200. Are you with me?
Yes.
And that is equal to 500. Happy?
Yes.
And now tell me what is change in the position. So position at time t equal to 0. वो माइनस करना है पोजीशन एट टाइम इक्वल टाइम टी इक्वल टू 15. दिस इज चेंज इन द पोजीशन एज एक्स 0 इज 0 देयरफॉर दिस चेंज इन पोजीशन विल बी सेम एज एक्स 15 दैट इज 100 फीट. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस.
सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट देयर आर थ्री क्वांटिटीज हियर. वन इज चेंज इन पोजीशन. आर यू विद मी? द सेकंड इज पोजीशन एट द एंड ऑफ टाइम इंटरवल और एट टाइम टी इक्वल टू 15 सेकंड एंड थर्ड थिंग इज डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल. All these three quantities can have different values. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So can I give, I will make it more clear by another example. Let us say when you started observing the motion at t equal to 0 seconds, the particle was already at distance 100 feet. Are you with me?
Yes.
With reference to the origin O. And this is positive x direction. So with reference to the origin, the particle was already at 100 feet. So what is the position? X0. Can you tell me? Plus 100?
Yes, sir.
Do you agree with me? Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then at t equal to 10 seconds, the particle reached to this position where this distance is 400 feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the position at t equal to 10 seconds? Tell me.
The 400.
So it is plus 400 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And at time t equal to 10 seconds, the particle reverses its velocity and starts traveling back. Are you with me? And this particle occupies this position at t equal to 15 seconds. And how much distance does it travel back? Let us say it travels back 100 feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the position at x is equal to 15 seconds? What is the position? Tell me.
The 300 feet.
300 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So these are the values of position of a particle. They are to be written with the sign because they are vector quantities and direction is taken care of by the sign. So don't just write 100 feet, write it as plus 100 feet. Are you with me? So you are specifying the magnitude and you are specifying the direction as well. Because it is rectilinear motion, direction can be taken care of by only positive and negative signs. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So ye hua x 15. Now, Let me ask you the question. What is the change in position from t equal to 0 to t equal to 15 seconds? T equal to 0 to t equal to 15 seconds may. What is the change in position? So if I were to calculate change in position delta x, what I have to do is I have to subtract x0 from x15. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And how much is that? Tell me.
300 minus 100.
300 minus 100.
100.
That is 200. Are you with me? Feet.
Yes, sir.
Is it different than the position at t equal to 15 seconds?
Yes,
it is. So change in position during t equal to 0 seconds t equal to 15 seconds is different than the position at x is equal to 15 at t equal to 15 seconds. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
And if I now ask you, what is the distance traveled from time t equal to 0 seconds to t equal to 15 seconds? That is altogether different quantity. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
That is how much? Tell me.
300.
That is 300 plus 100. Do you agree with me? It traveled distance 300 and then came back by 100 feet. But even if it comes back, it has to travel the distance. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So this distance is 400 feet. So have you understood the difference between position at t equal to 15 seconds, change in position from t equal to 0 seconds to t equal to 15 seconds, and distance traveled during t equal to 0 seconds to t equal to 15 seconds? Do you know my difference? Do you agree with me?
Yes.
So what is the crucial step that we must take to find out the distance traveled? Batao.
तो ऐड करना पड़ेगा सर.
नहीं, पर क्या ऐड करना है उसके लिए? व्हाट इज द डिसाइडिंग क्राइटेरिया? फर्स्ट यू विल हैव टू लोकेट वेयर द रिवर्सल ऑफ वेलोसिटी हैज ऑकर्ड. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
इफ देयर इज नो रिवर्सल ऑफ वेलोसिटी, देन चेंज इन पोजीशन विल बी सेम एज द डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल. देखो क्या स्टेटमेंट कर रहा हूं. इफ देयर इज नो वेलोसिटी reversal, that means at t equal to 0 seconds the particle was here, at t equal to 15 seconds the particle was here, and at t equal to 30 seconds the particle is here. Are you with me?
Yes.
And there is no change in velocity. The velocity was always in this direction. In that case, change in position itself will be the total distance traveled. Do you agree with me?
Yes sir.
So total distance traveled and change in position, इनमें difference कब आएगा? Only when the velocity has reversed the direction. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And how do you identify the points where there is a possibility of reversal of velocity? कैसे identify?
Acceleration zero हो जाएगी.
नहीं, velocity zero हो जाएगी. देखो, if velocity is positive and if it has to reverse, then at some point it must become zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
ऐसे भी हो सकता है, the velocity drops down, becomes zero here, and again gains in the positive direction itself. तो ऐसा necessary नहीं है कि v equal to zero होने के बाद direction of motion reverse हुआ ही होगा. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But if there is a reversal of direction of motion, then the velocity must be zero at some point. Are you with me?
Yes.
So velocity becoming zero is the probable point of reversal of direction of motion. I am saying probable. Are you with me?
Yes.
And to be on safer side, we will find out all such points where velocity becomes zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Now let us go back to our problem. Chalo. Is problem mein zara aap mujhe batao. टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल व्हेन टी इक्वल टू 7 सेकंड्स. सो कहां से कहां तक टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल हमें कैलकुलेट करना है? टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल आई विल डिनोट इट बाय डी. कहां से कहां तक? 0 सेकंड से लेके 7 सेकंड्स तक.
7 सेकंड.
आर यू विद मी? सो वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल ड्यूरिंग द टाइम इंटरवल 0 सेकंड टू 7 सेकंड. आर यू विद मी?
यस.
सो द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट आर the points or what are the time instances at which velocity became zero during time t equal to 0 second to time t equal to 7 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes.
And how do I find out that? Do you have the expression for velocity? Batao.
Yes sir. V equals to t square plus 16.
Minus t square plus 16. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
V is equal to minus t square plus 16. Are you with me? I am now going to equate this to zero. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then once you do that, you are going to get two roots. Konse roots hai batao? T is equal to
plus or minus
4 seconds. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So at time t equal to plus 4 seconds or time t equal to minus 4 seconds, the velocity must be zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, which route will you accept and which route will you discard?
Plus 4.
And why do you discard t equal to minus 4?
Because time reverse nahi kar sakte.
So that is the misconception. So that's where I was leading to. Zara dekho, t equal to minus 4 second doesn't mean that you are reversing the time. So to understand this, again we are going to take a digress. You are going to tell me, what do you understand by t equal to 0? T equal to 0 ka meaning kya hai? Batao.
हम यहाँ से शुरू कर रहे हैं कैलकुलेट कर.
नहीं, is it the time of commencement of the motion?
Yes, sir.
Nahi. So t is not the time of commencement of motion. The motion may also have prevailed before t equal to 0. But t equal to 0 is the time when observer starts observing. Are you with me?
Yes.
T is equal to 0 refers to the time when observer starts observing the motion. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Ab zara dhyan do, pure dhyan se suno main kya keh raha hu. Observing. It is not like the motion was not prevalent before t equal to 0. No. T equal to 0 is the time when the observer started his stopwatch and he started observing the motion. Agar t equal to 0 would have been the commencement of motion, we would not be in a position to observe the motion of a moon around the earth. Do you agree with me? Because at that time we were not there.
Yes, sir.
When the motion began, when moon started revolving around the earth, we were not there. But still, we are in the position to observe the motion parameters of moon around the earth. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So when, what is t equal to 0 then? T equal to 0 is when the observer started observing the motion. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what does t equal to minus 4 second mean? T equal to minus 4 second ka meaning kya hai? Batao.
सर तब मोशन हो रही थी पर हमने कैलकुलेट नहीं किया था
शो नहीं किया था और मे नॉट हैव बीन देयर टी इक्वल टू माइनस 4 सेकंड रेफर्स टू 4 सेकंड्स प्रायर टू ऑब्जर्वर स्टार्टेड ऑब्जर्विंग द मोशन डू यू एग्री विद मी
यस
एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी डिस्कार्ड दैट रूट बिकॉज़ ऑब्जर्वर वाज नॉट ऑब्जर्विंग सो व्हाट इज द पॉइंट व्हाट इज द फन इन टॉकिंग अबाउट वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सीलरेशन देयर व्हेन ऑब्जर्वर वाज नॉट ऑब्जर्विंग एग्री विद मी
यस
So t equal to minus 4 second is to be discarded, not because the time cannot go in the reverse direction. No, that's the foolish explanation. The explanation is t equal to 0 corresponds to the instant when observer started observing the motion, and we know nothing about the motion prior to that. So t equal to minus 4 refers to 4 seconds before observer started observing, and therefore we are going to discard this. Are you with me?
Yes.
And now, so the another possible route is t equal to 4 seconds. Does it lie within 0 to 7 seconds? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Are you with me? So t equal to 4 seconds is the time at which the velocity may have reversed its direction. We don't know for sure, but it is possible that the velocity may have reversed the direction. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So now it is always better to split the time interval between 0 to 4 seconds and then from 4 to 7 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes.
And what I am going to do now, I am going to find out change in position from time t equal to 0 to 4 seconds and change in position from time equal to 4 to 7 seconds, and I am going to neglect their sign and I am going to add them to find out the total distance. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, tell me what is x0. What is the position when time equal to 0? Nothing is given. So, we assume that it starts from 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
What is the value of x4? How do we calculate this value? So, in this expression, we have to put t equal to 4 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So put t equal to 4 seconds and tell me the value. How much is that?
Plus 17 by 3.
Plus
17 by 3.
Others, please in chat box respond if it is correct. I want one independent confirmation. Plus 17 by 3. So now, what is the change in position change in position delta x during 0 to 4 seconds. How do I calculate that? So it is nothing, this is nothing but x4 minus x0. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Do you agree with me? Yeah. So somebody please confirm this is plus 17 by 3, and in that case, then delta x from x equal to 0 to 4 seconds is going to be equal to plus 17 by 3. Somebody please confirm in chat box. Are you with me? Are you with me, Aftab?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Am I pronouncing your name correctly?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So it is plus. Why it is plus 17 by 3? Mind you, we have taken change in position. As x0 is 0, therefore it is plus 17 by 3. If x0 would not have been 0, this would be x4 minus value of x0. Happy?
Yes.
Yes. Now what is x4? X4 we have already calculated. X4 value is plus 17 by 3. And what is the value of x7? X7 you have already calculated. How much is that? Tell me. Plus 2 inches. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Plus 2. So what is the, what is change in position during time 4 to 7 seconds? 4 to 7 seconds. So how do I write that? X7 minus x4.
Minus x4.
So how much is that? Tell me. 2 minus 17 by 3.
Minus 11 by 3.
Minus 11 by
3.
3. So now observe. Change in position from 0 to 4 seconds is positive. That means the object kept moving in positive x direction. Or ultimately, it was moved by positive x direction. But from x 4 to 7 seconds, the change in position is negative. That means the object came back. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Okay. Now, how do we calculate total distance? We disregard the signs. So, total distance traveled during 0 to 7 seconds now is the summation of magnitudes of these two. So, 17 by 3 plus 11 by 3. We are going to take only magnitudes. Are you with me? And how much is that?
Yes.
Tell me.
28 by 3 inches.
So it is 28 by 3 inches. Happy?
Yes.
So this question was crucial. So what are the steps that we are going to do for total distance calculated? In the given time duration, we will first find out where the velocity becomes zero. Are you with me?
Yes.
So let us say you have to find out total distance traveled from time t equal to t1 to time t equal to t2. Are you with me?
Yes.
Aapko total distance find out karna hai time t1 se t2 tak. Are you with me? So first of all, you are going to find out at how many locations does the velocity become zero. It may so happen that for more than one location, the velocity will become zero. For example, let us say the velocity is zero at time t equal to t star and time t equal to t double star. These both the times they lie in t equal to t1 to t2. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So how will you calculate total distance traveled? So you will calculate change in position from t to t star. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Then t star to t, t star to t double star. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And then from t double star to t2. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And you will take only, you will consider only magnitudes of this change in position and you will add them together to get the total distance traveled. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the problem thoda sa mushkil tha, but you have to only understand the concept between change in position and total distance traveled. If that is, if you are thorough in that, you will be able to solve the problem. Now, this is a simple version of problem where acceleration was directly described as the function of time. Samajh mein aa raha hai ye kaun se class ka problem hai? In this, acceleration velocity, both this are directly described as functions of time. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
And now let us go to the next problem. Can you read the statement of next problem for me? Please read it.
The acceleration of a particle is defined by the relation a equals to minus k by x. It has been experimentally determined that the v equals to 15 feet per second when x equals to 0.6 feet and that v equals to 9 feet per second when x equals to 1.2 feet. Determine a the velocity of the particle when x equals to 15 feet, 1.5 feet. The position of the particle at which its velocity is zero.
Right. So now this is the another class of problem where acceleration is described as a function of position. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Unlike the first problem where acceleration was defined as the function of time. Now here the acceleration is defined as function of position. Are you with me?
Yes.
This is another class of problem. For such class of problems, we are going to use this expression. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
What is the expression? A is equal to dv by dx. Happy?
Yes.
So I am going to write down A is equal to dv by dx. This is my expression. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And here I am going to substitute A as minus k by x. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Where k is the constant with reference to now position. Because the differential equation is cast in position, we are going to say k is constant with reference to the position. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So k is constant minus k by x has to be equal to dv by dx. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
How do you solve this differential equation? So we have to first bring it in variable separable form.
Yes, sir.
A variable separable form means all constant terms and terms involving in x, bring them together. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what do we need to do? Take this dx on the other side. So what do we get? Minus k by x time dx is equal to dv.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Will it be v dv by dx? A equals to v dv.
Yeah, it is v dv by dx. I'm sorry. Yes, we have proven it as v dv by dx. Sorry, you are absolutely right. So A is equal to v dv by dx, and value of A I have substituted it as minus k by x. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so minus k by x dx is equal to dv. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Is it in variable separable form? I'm sorry, it is vdv. This has to be vdv. So is it already in variable separable form? Yes. So can I now integrate left hand side with reference to x and right hand side with reference to v?
Yes.
Chalo, so integrate. So how? Now, to do the integration, now it is better to do definite integration so that we can avoid the constants. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. So what are the conditions given? V is equal to 15 feet per second when x is equal to 0.6 feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And v equal to 9 feet per second when x is equal to 1.2 feet. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So chalo, ab left hand side mein I am going to integrate with reference to x. Kaha se kaha tak? 0.6 se leke 1.2 tak. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So I am integrating left hand side with reference to x from 0.6 to 1.2. Why? Because I know the velocities at these times, at these positions. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
It is minus k by x dx. Happy? This is equal to, this has to be now integrated with reference to velocity. What is the velocity when x is equal to 0.6 feet? Velocity is 9 feet per second. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the velocity? No, I'm sorry. It is 15%. 15. And what is the velocity when x is equal to 1.2 feet? Corresponding velocity, we have to write it here, 9. So we are going to do integration from 15 to 9. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, your calculators are equipped with for solving such kind of equations. You need not have the formulae. But you already know what is the integration of 1 over x. Bolo kya hai? Log x. Yes. Do you understand that? It is the integration. Sorry, it is log to the base e of x. Agreed? You need not do that. On calculator, you can directly solve this expression. So please do this integration and tell me how much is the left hand side. So let me do it with you. So integration tab is there on your calculator. Usme hame substitute karna hai minus 1 over x. You can take k outside the integration because it is constant and it is unknown. So take k outside, minus 1 by alpha x. And limits of integration are 0.6 to 1.2. So if you allow me, I will tell you the value of left hand side. That turns out to be minus 0.6931. 6931. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Times k, because k is sitting outside. And this has to be equal to, now let us integrate the right hand side. Mind you, and calculator, whatever is the integration, whatever is the variable of integration, you have to convert that in terms of x. So I am going to integrate x dx instead of v dv. You know that in definite integral, we can change the variable. Are you with me?
Yes.
So integration v dv will be same as integration x dx from 15 to 9. So do that on calculator.
You 72.
Get, yeah.
72.
Minus 72. Limits mein gadbad ki. Limit, lower limit is 15, upper limit is 9. Are you getting minus 72?
Yes, sir.
So what is the value of k? The value of k now turns out to be 72 divided by 0.6931. If anyone is getting any other value by calculation, please let me know. But this value turns out to be 103.8811. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This is the value. Substitute that here. Substitute that here. So what do we get? So therefore we get A is equal to minus k by x. So minus 103.8811 by x. Happy?
Yes.
Are you with me? Okay. And now what do we need to find out? Find out the velocity of particle when x is equal to 1.5 feet. Are you with me?
Yes.
So how are we going to do that? So zara dekho, yahi integration. Integration. X kitna diya hai? X is equal to 1.5. So I will integrate it from 0.6 to 1.5 feet. Are you with me?
Yes. 1.2.
Minus. Pardon?
So 1.2.
No, wait for that. So minus k 103.8811. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Minus k by x dx. This has to be equal to integration at x is equal to 0.6 feet. The velocity is 15 feet per second. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And at x is equal to 1.5 feet, it will be the velocity corresponding to x is equal to 1.5 feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And this is going to be v dv. Happy?
Yes, sir.
नाउ देर इज नो अदर गो देन यूजिंग द इंटीग्रेशन फॉर्मूला. सो अब क्या करना पड़ेगा, चलो सो टेल मी द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड हाउ मच इज दैट.
ln x 2
1 no right, left hand side can be evaluated directly on the calculator. Tell me that how much is that. So minus 103.8811 divided by alpha x and you have the limits from 0.6 to 1.5, so that turns out to be minus 95.1852. am I right? Aftab, can you tell me if this is correct? Nope. Is it correct? Calculator pe directly hota hai. You just tell me if it
yes,
is correct.
Sir.
Yes. And this has to be equal to right hand side. But what is the integration of velocity here? Now we have to do this integration. We have to write the formula v square by 2. Do you agree with me? And what are the limits of integration? 15 to v of 1.5. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So this is equal to v upper limit v of 1.5 square by 2 minus lower limit, that is 15 square by 2. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This is equal to minus 95.818852. So solve this now and tell me what is the value of v at t x is equal to 1.5. This also can be solved directly on the calculator. So I think you have got, you will get two roots of it, if I'm correct. So it is either minus 5.884 or it is plus 5.884. Am I right? It is feet per inches. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting the value?
Yes, sir. I am calculating.
Please calculate and tell me if this is correct. Feet per second. I'm sorry. करेक्ट है क्या?
यस सर.
यस एंड नाउ द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम, द पोजीशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल एट विच इट्स वेलोसिटी इज जीरो. आर यू विद मी? सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू, इंटीग्रेट फ्रॉम एक्स इज इक्वल टू 0.6 टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू द पोजीशन व्हेन वेलोसिटी इज जीरो. सो आई विल अज्यूम दैट एट x feet, the position x feet is the position at which velocity is zero. So I am going to call it as x of v equal to zero. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then what is the expression? Minus 103.88811. This divided by x. This must be equal to integration from 15 to 0. Velocity has become 0 here. Do you agree with me? And at x is equal to 0.6 feet, it is 15.
Yes.
Happy? V, dv. So, right hand side, you can easily evaluate. And left hand side, you have to do the similar thing that we have done earlier. So in tomorrow's class, you are going to tell me what is the value of x when v is equal to 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So this is the exercise for you to complete today. We will stop here for today. Write down your name and roll number in the chat box, and then you can. Those who have doubt can either type it in chat box or raise your hand so that I can answer. I can unmute you and I can answer those. If there is no doubt, then you can leave the class. Thank you.